it's John, the net guy, and today we're looking at the UCam, the world's first blockchain-enabled IP camera from Tenvis and IoTeX. Tenvis has provided the device hardware, and IoTeX's powerful blockchain technology encrypts all the videos this camera records. That's right, there's no signing up with a traditional and hackable username and password to be able to use this device. And you have complete control over your data from day one. You can choose to have the device run completely privately as well if you trust your private key management. More about that later. Hey, quick intro here if you're new to the channel. I create free tech how-tos and PC builds and tech product reviews on my channel about once a week. If I earn your sub by the end of the video and get to create more free content for you, I'd be honored if you smash that subscribe button and join the team. Now back to the show. So let's talk about the way it's similar to other pan-tilt IP cameras. It has an app that you can control the camera with, including the ability to completely set up the camera without having to plug it into wired Ethernet first, unlike some others. It has easy to follow voice prompts from the device, which was unexpected.
Welcome to UCam.
You use your smartphone to show it a QR code that lets it connect to your 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi.
UCam is connected.
And after a few additional steps, you can set it up to record events, alarm on motion, motion detection sensitivity, motion detection areas, and even set up local recording to an SD card if the cloud just isn't your thing. The size of the device is actually quite small, smaller than all of the other pan-tilt units that I've tested, and it's nearly completely silent in movement, which would make it a good baby monitor. The video quality is quite good actually, as I would expect from the other video products I've seen from Tenvis. Recorded videos have some compression artifacts, but as a nanny camera or local surveillance camera, it's plenty of resolution. It has two-way audio that works well, including one of the strongest speakers in any of the devices I've tested in the last few years. The audio is clear and unmuffled. You'll have no problem yelling your kids through it.
Hey kid, get off my lawn.
The only wire it needs to operate, in fact, is a single micro-USB cable connection, which provides it 5 volts power. I'm guessing it can be extended with the long-range micro-USB cables available on Amazon, or run off a large battery bank if you need to use it somewhere remotely. Panning and tilting works as expected, though the app likes to nag you if you move it too fast. And this is where the UCam starts to be different. It's the first camera I've used that doesn't require you to register with their app. You are issued a recovery key during the initial setup process, which you are responsible for. I recommend screenshotting it or printing it out, or both. They also include 2 cards that you can write this key down on and save it in a safe place. This key becomes your way to access the camera and all of your footage should you need to replace your phone or tablet. Once your UCam device has been set up with an active encryption key, there is no way to steal the camera even and access your videos because the camera itself is only part of the puzzle. There is a necessary backdoor that they offer if you so choose, a deregistration email address which will allow you to unlock the device if you lose your key. They will let you deregister the camera and create new encryption keys, but that's only in the event that your old key is lost. I went through this process and it did not give me any access to previously recorded videos, though I was able to reuse the device still. Speaking of recording options, they do offer cloud recording free for 10-second video clips up to 3 hours. 7 days and 20-second clips for $1.99 a month or $19 a year, and a full 30 days of storage and 30-second videos for $6.99 a month or $69.99 a year. You can avoid these fees, of course, by installing a microSD card and storing the video content locally. For as little as $7, you can install a 32-gig card, which will store days of video. While the industry of personal video security and monitoring is heating up with new offerings from Wyze, Amcrest, Arlo, RioLink, SimpliSafe, Nest, Blink, and others just to name drop a few, almost every vendor is charging you fees for storage or demanding that you sign up with their service with an email address. As a software engineer, privacy, and IT security buff, I can tell you that no centralized system is secure, including those in public or private clouds. A recent hack of Amazon Web Services showed that an internal support engineer at the cloud provider had backdoor access to Capital One's secured information systems and fraudulently used those records. Vulnerabilities in software come almost as quickly as one missing condition statement or a single character. So is this camera right for everyone? That's a tough question. They have made it remarkably easy to set up, use, and it's very affordable. It's not weatherproof, so you should only use it indoors. It also doesn't support LTE or other cellular connections. Wi-Fi or Ethernet is required for remote monitoring. Some privacy-conscious people may not like the idea of having a camera in their home, recording them 24/7. On the other hand, cameras can be a key factor in security, and I run at least 12 in and around my home. If I were to buy a camera for a sensitive area of my home, I believe this would be the one. In fact, it's the only one in my private office. If you want to try it out, Amazon has it for $39 today with free returns. A link for this exact device is in the video description and helps this channel without costing you anything extra. Thanks again for watching The Net Guy. If you found this content useful, toss me a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in a future video. Hey, thanks for making it to the end of my video. If you want, do me a solid, hit the like button down there. And if you didn't like it, tell me why in the comments. I would love to help you out. If you do need some tech help, you can hit us up on the Discord channel, links in the description below. And why not check out one of these other great videos? It's okay, I'll wait.